Addressing a press conference at the ministry headquarters in Kampala on the ongoing investigations before the Parliament's Trade Committee, the Minister of Trade, Francis Mwebesa, dismissed claims of used vehicles, saying he received a brand new car which is in good condition.
Which I know was purchased, the way it was purchased or not, but the car is the car which is working, it's a moving car, and it is a new car. Well, you can look around. We started with these top floors, which you will see, and they will explain to you how far they are going with it.
The Permanent Secretary, Geraldine Sally, who has become a subject of Parliament probe on issues of irregular procurement, trashed claims of used vehicles, saying all the five cars which were procured at 2.8 billion shillings were brand new models, 2021 and 2020.
Even the mileage, you will see none of the cars goes above 105. The biggest mileage was 105 kilometers, which means that it is a movement from the manufacturer all the way to the user. And there's every single minister, I actually got those cars myself and delivered them to the ministers. Why? For safety.
Sally noted that all vehicles were cleared by the chief mechanical engineer of the Minister of Works, and the direct procurement was approved by the Solicitor General since ministers had gone long without official cars.
Decided to go to the Solicitor General and we got clearance to accept our new method of bidding, which was restrictive bidding as well. And we managed to get Summerbolt to supply those cars. They brought the first two cars, then the next two, and then finally one. So they were delivered one by one, but they were still within budget.
Sally faulted the former procurement officer of the ministry, Alfred Lapiem, for all the noise about alleged procurement of vehicles. Alfred Lapiem appeared before the Trade Committee of Parliament on Monday and pinned his former boss for flouting procurement rules.
But he has saved money because we had inflated the prices. But he's the one who had inflated the prices. He came up with a value of 3.205 billion. Yet the person who was supposed to take the contract was 2.282 billion. The difference is 385 million. That's an inflation of 14%.
On the issue of diverting 5 billion shillings meant for renting new office premises at Kingdom Kampala Building to renovate existing offices at Farmer's House on Parliamentary Avenue, Sally is proud that she made a huge saving for government because the ministry only spends 141 million shillings on rent in the current premises.
All the approvals. Now, this money would have been for rent. For me, as an accountant, it falls under accommodation. Whether you're renting or whether it's your own home, it's all accommodation. So I spoke to the PSST, who cleared me and said, well, you know what, I think what you're saying makes sense.
She also dismissed allegations of spending 400 million shillings on relocation of ministry files from the ministry headquarters to stores in Entebbe, saying they spent only 59 million shillings, yet they had a number of activities involved. She went on to disregard alleged inflation of renovation costs.
With you, you will see that the costs of transporting those records to Entebbe came to 59.3 million. It included fuel, it included hiring the people who were collecting all the records from each office and taking them and loading them and also offloading them in Entebbe and parking them in the rooms where we were supposed to be.
She committed to face the committee upon fresh summons sanctioned against her. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.